name's Anders Kokon. I'm working as a brewmaster at Carlsberg, Denmark. I started as a chemical engineer. I shared an apartment with two friends. Where we were all students, so we had to get some cheap alcohol. And the easiest way was to start brewing our own beer. The exciting thing about my work is the processes. It's the chemical processes, it's live yeast, it's changing raw materials depending on the year. And it's, of course, the scale. More challenges by going in big size compared to when I did it in the apartment 30 years ago, something like that.
One of the things that are separating Carlsberg from other breweries is the research center and the commitment to research throughout the history of Carlsberg. We're basically constantly moving, trying to improve all the time. That's what I really enjoy.
I think my passion for barley actually originates back to my childhood. My father has a farm in the northern part of Jutland where he has been growing quite a lot of wheat barley, but certainly also malting barley for many, many years. I was with him in the field and I love to see how plants are growing and, you know, also the seasons during the year and how, you know, also how that's impacting a farmer's life and all our lives. What has been really exciting for us is that this year we actually was able to publish the barley genome sequence. And that has been taking almost 10 years to, you know, find the full sequence of the barley genome. It means that now we know actually every single gene in this plant here.
Since I started working in Carlsberg 20 years ago, a lot has changed, of course. Carlsberg has grown, but I think most significantly in production is the focus on the environment. And since then, we have basically halved our consumption of energy and water. And I actually don't think we've met the end of the road. I think we can go even further.
This is the heart of the brewery. It's the control room, so we control everything from here, all the malt coming in, all the other raw materials coming in, and distributing beer out to the packaging lines. We produce more than half the beer drunk in Denmark. We are 35 people to produce it, so it's more than 3 million hectoliters per year.
I find hops very, very fascinating because of all the good things it actually gives to the beer. I mean, you have one is a bitterness, number two is aroma, number three is the potential for creating a great foam or head on the beer. It's the king of plants, I would say. It's fantastic.
Hello, my name is Uli and this is my father Hubert. We are here on our farm and there we plant the best hops.
You would actually see these hop vines growing up to 6-8 meters, give you a lot of hop cones. If we can start growing hops locally in the Nordic regions, but also in Russia, with the colder climates, I think that that will save us a lot also on sustainability, carbon footprinting, and so forth.
During the boiling, we add the hops. You can see it's small pellets. It's basically the flower of the hop plant, which is pelletized. And it's like the spice of beer. So you can have different hops with different kinds of flavors. Some will taste like citrus, some will taste like cheese. On top of these tanks, it's nice to go up after a hard day to have a look at the surroundings. It's a beautiful view up here, especially if the sun is shining like today.
I'm absolutely confident that also within the next 50 years there will be plenty of possibilities to improve our raw materials, our barley, our yeast, our hops even more than today. Savings on water, on energy, and I think it's so exciting to look forward to what the next 20, 30 years will bring for farmers, for the beer drinkers, and certainly also for all the scientists who will be heavily involved in this work.